Hi, I'm Sarah, and today I'm going to be reacting to Right Through Me by Even of Day. I love Day 6 and Even of Day. By now, you probably know that. I know that each member goes through his own storyline in the video. I saw like a thread of screenshots, but that's all I know, so I don't know how the storyline plays out and I know nothing about the song, so I'm just very excited. Before I get into this reaction, if you liked it at the end of it, please don't forget to leave a like and maybe subscribe if you want to see more of my videos. And I have a Patreon account where I'll be listening to this album, and I just uploaded a Negentropy album listen. So if you're interested in seeing that, the link is in the description. I read through the lyrics for the song. First of all, I have to say, I really loved the concept pictures and the entire design of the teasers and all of that. It really reminded me of, like, is it 90s? Like grunge music. So I'm really excited to hear this song. I have kind of a hope, I guess, that it's really heavy, kind of like Rescue Me in that direction. I don't know if it will be though, because these lyrics are kind of really like angsty and just hurt and sad. I feel like it's not gonna be what I expect, but I'm gonna really like it. The story I'm getting out of the lyrics is pretty sad. Like a relationship, the person singing kind of feels like is like it's over already, but they're hanging on to it. The other person is shutting them out completely, like they're not really talking to them anymore, they kind of just ignore them. So it's like a breaking relationship, and the person singing is trying to cope with all of the hurt that they're experiencing. All right, let's watch it. I'm very excited. Oh my god, let's watch it. I'm very excited for this. Oh wow, that's already so cool. Oh wow. Oh my god, I have great feelings about this. Okay, I don't know. Whoa, that's fucked up. Oh my god. Don't let the... Wait, I'm gonna cry. Oh god. Oh my god, wait, I'm gonna cry. You're gonna set that room on fire if you keep knocking over lamps. This is so interesting. The ding ding ding. Oh, I'm gonna cry. I'm experiencing so many feelings.
Oh my Oh, I have like goosebumps. Oh my god, Yankee. You good? Oh Jesus. Okay, wait. Oh my god, that's like a lot of feelings that I'm going through right now. Okay, let me sort it. First of all, I really like the song. I wasn't responding a lot to the song. I was in the video. The song is definitely different from what I expected. It's not at all as hard as I expected it to be. It didn't even sound sad necessarily. It just kind of sounded like slow and melancholic a little bit. So the song is really great. I definitely need to listen to it without watching the video because the video is really making me very emotional. And it's pulling all of my focus, so I need to listen to the song again just to know what it sounds like by itself. I freaking knew that the dog storyline would make me cry. I love animals so much. He let go of the leash. That was it for me. Like, you just lost, like, you lost your dog and you don't know if you're gonna find it again. I'm gonna cry. I don't know, like, animals are like such a topic for me. But I can also relate to the One Pill storyline a lot, so this video is just very emotional for me. I'm gonna talk more about the interpretations because I'm really fascinated by the stories in this video, and there's not too much that I can say on the technical level because there are no visual effects or like major CGI things going on. It's pretty much all, I think, mostly shot on sets, maybe all of it. I could imagine some of the street shots with Dowon are in a real location. Maybe the music store is also a real location, not a set. Otherwise, it's just I really love the color scheme and the production design is awesome. All of the detail and just the atmosphere they create and the setting and the mood. I really, really love it. I really, 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 really like this in the beginning, this when they're in the window. And I'm assuming this is a set. I don't think it's a real street. So I have to say the video is obviously fittingly to the story. It's kind of dark. Like the lighting in this video is very just in the space that they needed to be. It's not like an entirely lit up like space or anything. I absolutely love the color scheme of the video. This orange, green, neon kind of thing. It's just all throughout the video. The entire, like, the color scheme is everywhere and every shot is the same color scheme, which I love. A lot of K-pop music videos, for me it's difficult to like say an exact color scheme because a lot of videos kind of just are very colorful, so they kind of have all the colors, but in this video it's very clear. I don't think I've necessarily watched a movie that this corresponds to, but it just reminds me of like something. It's really weird. Like, I feel like this is an aesthetic or like a mood being portrayed that I've seen before, but I don't know where. Like, I have a reference in my head, but I don't know if it's a real one specific reference or if it's like a combination of things that I've seen before. So I can't really express it. Day 6 have a video that they shot in this kind of aesthetic where they were playing in a window, so that reminds me of that. Everything is so dark, the things that are lit up, not even his face, we can't even see his face because it's in the shadow. And this is, again, I would say a set, like a room that they built the walls in and put in all of the furniture and the wallpaper and the carpet. Again, also what she's wearing, also the red. Even the wardrobe fits in the color scheme perfectly. And then we have this one red flower, a lot of greens and yellows. One Pill is wearing a red shirt as well. And then we have this one spotlight on him. So again, everything else is in darkness. That's what I meant before with the lighting. Like, it's a very specific lighting. They knew exactly where they needed light and everything else could be in the darkness. Oh my god, I didn't even notice that cut. Oh my god, so cool. I think it's just a 3-frame dissolve transition because I don't think this was done with a programmed camera or anything because it's on different locations. I think it's just like it worked out in editing that the framing was similar enough to have this edit work. Look how interesting this lighting is. We have two spotlights up here on the wall, but then we also have lighting coming in from the windows, and this window on this side casts this shadow. It's all of the like contrast and different patterns and textures, but also with the lighting, it's really, really cool. And then these effects. So this, I don't know if this is real or not. I think it is real. I don't think it's CGI, just because of the way that the light is changing. It looks very practical. Like every light is being cut off naturally, as it would really look if it was cut, like, you know what I'm trying to say. But this is also really interesting. I love the lens. I'm assuming they shot this on a fish lens because it's very distorted, but it's kind of not distorted in the way that a fish eye lens would distort the frame. It's kind of distorted in a curve rather than a circle. So I don't know if this is a special type of lens or if they did something in editing. I don't know, but I really like this shot. And the slow motion, the depth of field, him being perfectly lit up and everything else being so dark. I love the cinematography in this video. I wonder if this is real. It looks real. Wow, Youngkae. Obviously not real glass, but I don't think this is visual effects. I think, I don't know what it's called, like sugar glass or something, you know, just some kind of breakable glass that you can jump through without hurting yourself. And also I love this entire aesthetic, the way it's so blurry in the back and the lighting coming from here and the colors just being so in focus. Love Parade. Is that maybe another song on the album? So for a Duo One storyline, I'm just gonna share my interpretation. I'm not saying that's exactly what's happening. I feel like it's not actually about the dog, like, oh, the dog doesn't care for me anymore, it's ignoring my words or whatever. But for me, more that something happened to him, like a relationship, whatever happened in that relationship affects him so much that he's not even, that he either he can't experience and feel love anymore, or he's just so in his head that he doesn't realize what's happening around him because he's like not paying attention at all. He's just staring ahead and just going about his day, kind of like the daily routine, the shit he always has to do, like go walk his dog. His storyline isn't really about losing the dog, but more losing focus of the love that is in his life. That's the way I would interpret it. So then we go to One Pill storyline. I find personally One Pill storyline to be the most abstract because we never see anyone else in his storyline. Like we see this picture, but he's always in the same room. So I don't really know what exactly happened. I don't think there's an explicit storyline in the video. At least I don't see one. Maybe I'm missing it. I'm always missing stuff all the time. So, but my interpretation, obviously he's already a grown up, but kind of the way he behaves and also that he's always in that one room, it makes me think personally of a dysfunctional family where maybe the parents were fighting each other and he was kind of caught in the middle. Like the way he like hides in this corner with the blankets, it just makes me think of parents are fighting outside the door and the kid is like in their room, like covering their ears because they don't want to hear it and they're scared. It makes me think of that. I was honestly expecting that this room would set on fire at some point because he keeps knocking over lamps. Maybe also another thing that could have been happening in the story is like he is visiting his childhood home and reliving all of the memories or like experiences, and then he's like letting them out and tearing down the room, maybe? Like, look at him, he's fucking terrified. He looks completely out of it. It's very scary. I don't like that at all. I don't really know what this cage means. It could be like a metaphor for him being trapped in a bad situation, or literally the parents locked him in his room and he never got to leave it. And that's why he's so angry and destroys everything because he grew up in that room and never being able to leave it. Or also him thinking of a pet that he kind of treated the same way as his parents treated him, like locked up in this cage and like he never let it out. Or kind of like a parallel with Duwon's story where like he was so caught up in his own stuff that he didn't really pay attention and really didn't take care of his pet. I don't know, there are so many interpretations. Also the acting in this video is like the scenes in the back here when they all cry, where's the Oscar? Maybe all of the stories are connected, like maybe Youngkae's story, like Youngkae and his wife, they're the parents of One Pill, right? And then One Pill has this cage, which is kind of, I'm thinking of an animal, which just connects to Duwon's story. So maybe there's like a, you could see it that way too, if you looked into it. I don't necessarily see how this set relates to the rest, to the storylines of the video. I could imagine it's kind of a thing of something about what they display to the public and what's really going on, kind of a thing like that. I'm assuming, or maybe it's just like an aesthetic choice, I don't know. Well, in the lyrics they say, I try to help you, but you can't see me even though I'm here. But maybe in this case it's kind of like they need help, but everyone doesn't really see that even though they're right in front of them. Does that make sense? But also again, oh my god, I have so many interpretations. Like the cage, it's also kind of like this thing because there's no exit. Like they're in a cage and people are watching them from the outside, like tapping on the window kind of a thing. It's all a metaphor for each other. Everyone is the same. We are all gonna die. So again, maybe the ending also of the video is again kind of them breaking out, either breaking out of the cage. So One Pill's cage that we saw was a metaphor for the window that they're playing in. Or it's a thing of people are watching us through this glass, but they don't really connect to us because they don't know what's going on behind the scenes. So jumping through the glass is kind of like, okay, we'll share with you how we feel. Or maybe it's like we're right in front of them, but nobody pays attention. So if I jump through the window, then they're gonna pay attention because like I did something big. I don't know, there are so many ways to interpret this video. It's very fascinating to me. I love it. I'm having a really great time with this video. And this is a very special video for me because usually, if you know me, I'm really bad at picking up on stories and video, or like I'm never really like brave enough to say my interpretation of a video because I feel like I'm too stupid to understand what's really going on. But this video for me is very open-ended. Maybe it's not at all, so then I am stupid. But I don't know, there's just, for me, I see a lot of ways that you could interpret this, so that makes me excited. If I missed anything, let me know in the comments and I'll try to look at it and explain it to you or something. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this reaction. If you did, don't forget to leave a like. As always, a huge thank you goes to all of my patrons, especially Isabel, Pineapple Senpai, Heiho, Jeho, and Felipo for supporting me. If you're interested in checking out my Patreon, the link is in the description. And please let me know what you thought of the song, of the album, of the video, what your interpretation is of the video, if you agree with any of the theories that I said. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Bye!